just not like Spain where it gets boring because the sun comes out all the time. In England, you never know what's going to happen. Today I'm having a shower. Tomorrow I could be sunbathing.
So that's the unusual arrangement I'm talking about to open the lock gates. You actually wind it round rather than having to push it. It is novel. That's on the Henhurst Canal Bridge, which was rebuilt in 2006. So this is lock one going up. The approach is underneath a massive railway bridge, which obviously is Pigeon City. But actually what is more annoying is that the anti-vandal lock on the left-hand gate doesn't unlock, so you can't wind the paddle up. So you've got to do this just on one paddle on the right-hand gate. The lock leaks like a sieve, which makes it extremely difficult to get the lock empty enough to open the gate. So this is the second lock going up on the Wigan flight. It's actually bridge number 53, Britannia Bridge. The original stone bridge was opened in 1816. October the 22nd. You because it's right next to the road, it's got the winding arrangement to open the lock gates because there isn't room for a beam bar. So this is the third lock in the flight, lock 83, third one going up. So I don't know if all the locks are like it, but this third one going up, there's absolutely no moorings. Yeah, so on the lock landing, there's no rings or mooring posts. So I had to bang a pin in to hold the boat while I went and set the lock. Not very convenient, really. All the water coming in on the side of the lock has actually covered the well deck and the side windows. These locks have proven to be a bit of a challenge. The fact that there's nowhere to tie up the centre line to while I set the lock is a real nuisance. I never bang a pin in to hold it. Otherwise the boat would just go floating off down the canal. Just walk with it, just as long as we ain't lost the rope, it's alright. Okay, it's Sunday morning of the Women's World Cup game. I'm going to watch, so I'm starting out early to try and get two or three locks done before the kick-off at 11 o'clock. I think the women's football's better than the blokes. They don't. There's no histrionics with them. They just get on with the job. Anyway, that's another subject, isn't it? So I've set the first two locks that I've got to do this morning, which will be lock number 5 and 6, going up the Wigan Flight. I believe it's 81 in real terms, but I'm calling it 5 and 6 because I'm going up. I did 4. Before I stopped for the night, so I stopped immediately after lock number 4, which was pleasant enough. The next lock is surrounded by housing, all very interesting. the water's leaking through those lock gates like a sieve. The front of the boat's going to get wet. It's a little bit easier today. The wind's not blowing like it was yesterday. So that was, for me, lock number 5 going up, surrounded by houses, and also surrounded by houses on the right hand side of the bank, but you can't see them because of the trees and bushes that are there. So we're now heading to lock number 6, which I've actually been upset, so I'm going to drive straight into these lock gates. So this is lock 76 on the Wigan Flight. We've done 5 this morning. I'm having a breather now. Time for some breakfast. It is quite scenic really. And this particular lock, there's a plaque on it. Rebuilt by British Waterways Board 1988. Of course, they've been superseded by Canal and River Trust. So we're halfway up the Wigan Flight, and the pound that we need to go out of on lock 73 isn't deep enough. So the volunteers had to run up the top and let some water down the system. And I think that's going to take a while. This is a really deep lock, and we're only, I don't know, 3/4 of the way up because the level of the water's dropped so much. Filming a guy who's filming me. I'm putting something around the propeller. I think there's something around the propeller. I'll see if I can get it through this. Right.
look at that anyway.
So there's a mural on the side of this house, look, and it's to Wigan's industrial past. It looks, it's really nice, looks really made a nice job of that. Few gongoozlers at this one. Gotcha. This boat's on YouTube if you want to.
Oh, it's actually quite
the name.
Pop Chivers.
Yeah. And if you want to be on it, give us a wave. Okay, it won't be tonight because I'm a few weeks behind, but you'll be on there eventually.
Tonight?
No, it won't be. I've got time to do it tonight.
Rubbish is there, look, behind you.
Right, yeah.
And everything's on your left.
Oh,
so you'll go left
out of it. Yeah.
But also, you know that.
Oh, yeah. I need to check. Yeah, thank you. I think I need to check my weed patch actually. Seems to be struggling.
Weed.
Thanks ever so much. It's a sea of green. It's actually quite smelly over there. Anybody for pea soup?
Can't see anything.
No. Plastic bag for a start.
There's actually
some cardboard here that
we haven't thrown away. Let's go back to that rubbish place. We've got a saucepan here as well.
Take it over there then.
I'm going to. That's just what I'm doing. And the bottle that we've got already.
Fuck.
Get rid of it all. Do you want a bag to put stuff in?
No. So, the Wigan Flight of Locks. A lot of them are in very poor condition. And without the volunteers who know all the vagaries of which locks didn't work quite correctly and which one it was best to open a certain gate because the other one sticks and that, I think I'd have been in a bit of trouble. It's real experience though. Oh, we're at the top now. I've got some neighbours that are playing some loud music. I don't know if you can pick it up in the background. They've got a good playlist actually, I like it. So a beautiful evening. I'm absolutely cream crackered. I've just had to get down in the weed hatch and clear God knows what out of it. Fishing line, old plastic bag, loads of weed. But it's all part of being a jolly boater, isn't it? But I'm enjoying a beer and I'm going to go and have a shower because I feel hot and sweaty. I hope you've enjoyed this video that I put together of it. Some of it might be a bit bitty because I couldn't concentrate on all of it where there was so much going on. And the last couple of locks I did, I definitely had stuff around the propeller and I wanted to get to the top and then sort that out later. I think the blokes just shot the wife actually. That gun just went off.